This gear is called Rats. Equipping the gear spawns 5 rats in specific positions behind your character that will try and stay in those positions behind your character as you move. For more information, keep watching. Rats looks like a pack of 5 rats. The rats are identical with gray fur, black eyes, and pink ears, nose, tail, and feet. The bottom halves of each rat are tinted green as if a light is being shone from below. When in use, the rats appear by your character. Each rat is around the size of your arm. The try-on button does not accurately represent the tool, however, because it has no handle and the rats spawn behind your character. The tool is earned through the Stranger Things 3 event and has the town and city, sci-fi, adventure, and RPG genres. Its attribute is social and the description says, "These ads are up to something, but what?" Stranger Things 3 premieres July 4 only on Netflix. The in-game icon is white text saying Stranger Things 3 Rats with no spaces. It has no tooltip. Like most gear, Rats is droppable. However, because it does not have a handle, dropping the tool makes it disappear. When equipped, 5 rats spawn behind your character. Each rat has 100 health points and a walk speed of 16. The first rat spawns and tries to stay 3 studs to the right of your character and 3 studs behind. The second rat spawns and tries to stay 3 studs to the left of your character and 3 studs behind. The third rat spawns and tries to stay 5 studs behind your character. The fourth rat spawns and tries to stay 3 studs to the right of your character and 8 studs behind. The fifth rat spawns and tries to stay 3 studs to the left of your character and 8 studs behind. Because the physics engine never fails to entertain, the small size of the rats means they sometimes slip through the terrain and fall to their deaths. So is Rats worth getting? Yes, because 2 reasons. Reason 1 being Rats. Also, it's free. If you have any other gear you want me to review, let me know in the comments. That is all for this review. Bye.